For the Jets, a 5'8 freshman, number 11, Courtney McCullough. A 5'6 sophomore, number 24, David Sherman. A 5'11 junior, number 31, Latarius Stevens. A 5'10 sophomore, number 41, Gavin Mitchell. And a 6'1 junior, number 54, James Hornacher. The Jets are coached by Elliot Jackson. Thank you. ABA foul number 31, Materius. For both teams, for Wes-Del, number 22, Eli Durr. Grade piano number 44, Corday Jackson. Wes-Del Hall on number 3, Tyler Summers. Checks in for Anderson Prep. John Cook into the game for Wes-Del. So your slots are checked back in for Wes-Del. As a reminder, we have a couple of special events during halftime of tonight's varsity game. First, a Warrior cheerleading clinic.
Thank you.
forced a foul on number 10, Abdullah here. Kevin Mitchell will shoot two.
Thank you.
Wes-Del foul on number 14, Jared Ladd. Eli Durr checks back in for Wes-Del. Anderson Prep takes a 30-second timeout.
You're good at basement basketball.
We're good at your insurance.
Start with Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance, online, over the phone, or in person, and stop knocking on wood.
One thing, so I run to the phone and dial the number for Pizza King. I'm gonna ring the king. The king delivers.
This is your IHSAA. This is your state. This is your high school. This is your athletic association.
Fans, I'm IHSA Commissioner Paul Knighty, and we're here to make sure that all of this remains yours.
This is your state. This is your community. This is your IHSAA.
James Hornacher back in the game for the Jets. Carter Flynn checks in for Wes-Del.
Thank you.
checking in for Wes-Del, number 25, Mason Davis. And Wes-Del takes a full timeout.
Looking for high-quality fuel and tasty food on the go in Gaston? Look no further than Johnson's Oil. We are a family-run business that's been serving the local community for generations. Our convenience store offers a wide range of snacks, drinks, and other essentials, as well as delicious food, fish, chicken, tenderloins, and potato wedges. We're committed to supporting the local economy by hiring Wes-Del students and Gaston residents. Come visit us at Johnson Oil in Gaston.
Are you looking for a professional home improvement business in Muncie, Indiana? Call Property Pros. Remodeling, landscaping, electrical, you name it, we can help. Our team cares about your home just as much as you. We are quick and efficient with our work. We are your one call for all your residential and commercial home repair, remodel, and maintenance needs. We've got the best team around with decades of talent and expertise. Give us a call today to schedule your professionals to complete your project. Are you looking for a professional home?
Looking for high-quality fuel and tasty food on the go in Gaston? Look no further than Johnson's Oil. We are a family-run business that's been serving the local community for generations. Our convenience store offers a wide range of snacks, drinks, and other essentials, as well as delicious food, fish, chicken, tenderloins, and potato wedges. We're committed to supporting the local economy by hiring Wes-Del students and Gaston residents. Come visit us at Johnson Oil in Gaston.
Thank you.
APFL on number 43, Connor Ring. Anderson Prep takes a full timeout. I just received word.
You're good at basement basketball. This is your IHSAA. This is your state. This is your high school. This is your athletic association.
Fans, I'm IHSA Commissioner Paul Knighty, and we're here to make sure that all of this remains yours.
This is your state. This is your community. This is your IHSAA.
One thing, so I run to the phone and dial the number for Pizza King. I'm gonna ring the king. The king delivers. I'm gonna ring the king. An incredibly delicious royal feast pizza on the best crust you ever tasted. Ring the king. Pizza King.
James Hornacher back in the game for Anderson Prep. is Carter Flynn. Checking in for Anderson Prep. And Tavion Reed, Xavier Nunn, Kamarion Chamberlain, Christopher Ramirez, and Cordae Jackson.
Thank you. evening, a Friday evening that we gave you some basketball. Hopefully a little bit better tonight than last night's game. But the Warriors here hosting the second game of this weekend doubleheader on a Friday, Saturday night. APA, Anderson Prep Academy, is in Richard E. Johnson Gymnasium. It's a full house, a full night. It's elementary night here at Wes-Del. And we also have the first inaugural Hall of Fame class. I am the superintendent, Kyle Mealy. Alongside me, as always, is the coach, Danny Hanson. He'll have the color. I'll have the play-by-play. And then our sideline from the booth, sideline reporter Matt Nuckols, head football coach, will also be joining us. We have Mr. Producer Andrew Romine next to us, and we're ready to roll here. Coach, hoping for a better outcome tonight, but what do you do coming off of a game like last night? Do you just erase it from your memory and just get down to business tonight?
Yeah, absolutely. And sometimes the best thing to do is, like you said, you got to get right back in and be ready to go tonight. So you don't have four practices to stew on it. You're right back in. And like you said, it's a great environment again. Great atmosphere tonight. A lot of kids running around. The elementary night always makes it fun. So I'm looking forward to a great night of basketball.
It is a great night. It looks like we're going to have the choir out here. It looks like it's the elementary choir tonight that's going to help us with our national anthem after the high school choir did it last night, so we're really excited about that. As I mentioned, the halftime entertainment will be the elementary cheerleaders, but we'll also be talking with elementary principal Todd Reagan. I'll be doing an interview with him at halftime, so stick around for that as we're getting ready for the national anthem. And then after the elementary cheerleaders perform and we talk with Mr. Reagan, we will have the first inaugural Hall of Fame, Athletic Hall of Fame class at Wes-Del that will be presented here in front of the home audience, but also for you on the Wes-Del Sports Network. At this time, the flag's being dropped, and we're going to bring you the audio right here from Richard E. Johnson. One of the best sights you can see is the national anthem played here and performed by our elementary choir under the direction of Mrs. Williams,
ladies
elementary
and
choir
gentlemen,
teacher.
At this time, please rise and join the Wes-Del Elementary School Choir under the direction of Angel Williams as they honor our country by singing our national anthem.
And that was an excellent rendition of our national anthem by the Wes-Del Elementary Choir under the direction of Mrs. Angel Williams. Two great national anthems, I will say. I'm really impressed with both of our music program at the elementary and here at the high school. Our choir programs are headed in a really good direction. That's only the second year for both programs, and they're doing a really nice job. But back to basketball. APA comes into this one. Their record is 0-12. And their offensive average is 46.8 a game, and their defensive average is 66.9. So they're giving up quite a few more than they're scoring. But on the other side of that, Wes-Del's record is 5-8. Their offensive average is 54 points a game, and they're giving up 62. So could be an interesting one tonight. They're both teams struggling on defense. But if you watched last night, Coach, we were struggling on offense. What do you think the key tonight is to get us back into it offensively?
Well, the first key is staying out of foul trouble. I think that's going to be very important tonight. Like you said, is trying to and then get some easy buckets. Use the defense to get to offense. Obviously, high school basketball, you want to try to get as many easy buckets as you can. It's important to run good offense, but as many easy transition buckets, it'll make things a little easier.
Coach Nuckols, as you're looking at some stats for Anderson Prep, anybody that kind of jumps out at you as a scoring threat for them?
Yeah, they got three guys that lead them in scoring and do a majority of their scoring. One is guard number 14, Lincoln Fathauer. He's averaging about 9.8 points a game. He's a really good shooter, handles the ball well for him. Ben Scott, their senior big man, number 24, is their leading scorer, averaging just under 12 a game and a handful of rebounds. And then they have Zayden Finley, a junior, 6'3". He's averaging a little under 11 points a game and about 5 rebounds.
And coming into this one, Coach Hanson, if you're back there on the sidelines, do you look at this as a game to really reestablish your program? You know, you had a little stumble with Shenandoah. Our program's trying to get established. Coach McLaughlin always tries to run that fury, that trap. Do you bring that pressure tonight against Anderson Prep, knowing, you know, they're 0-12, but this is a scary game also because they have nothing to lose. Anderson Prep's coming into this hungry for a win.
Yeah, absolutely. When you got to be down, you got to get to your identity. Who are we? What do we do? And like you talked about, fury, that's what we do. We want to play up tempo. We want to put pressure on the ball. And you're going to see multiple defense tonight. I'm sure you're going to see some man switching, playing good, solid defense, but, you know, up tempo, pushing it and really trying to get some easy buckets. So, I'm sure, like you said, after last night, you know, been in those locker rooms, you know, as low as maybe it was right at the end of that game, here we are again tonight, and you get an opportunity to lace them back up. So, and again, high school sports is big on the environment and getting off to a good start. So, and we're at home again, which is always nice.
We've got a great home crowd tonight. We've got some of our Hall of Fame athletes in attendance as they're getting ready to be celebrated. So you really want to come out. I know Coach emphasized that. He talked to me before coming out here tonight that he really challenged them after the game last night. And then today he basically built them back up to say, you know, you have another opportunity here. So we're just getting ready for starting lineups. We're getting ready for the voice of the Warriors, Coach Biff Wilson, to announce both the APA starters and the Wes-Del starters. So we're going to take the audio down to the floor and Coach Wilson for the starting lineups.
Number 10, Abdullah Abdullah.
And there you have the starting lines for both teams getting ready for tip-off. John McLaughlin, in his 10th season, it is his final season. He has over 100 wins, 104 to be exact, just here at Wes-Del, the all-time winningest coach in Wes-Del history. But this is his final season. And so I'm sure that there's some emotion as each game passes for him, but also for these players who know it's his last season. They've been well aware of that for a while now. They want to perform and bounce back from last night's game, and he has definitely challenged them, and we'll see what happens here. Getting ready for tip-off here. Anderson Prep, Wes-Del, right here in Richard E. Johnson. And the Warriors control the tip. Trey Adams has it, and they'll get into their offense. Coach trying to look at this defense from APA. Looks like a zone.
Yeah, it is. It's a 2-3 zone. They started it as kind of a T look, and right off the bat, that's a good sign for the Warriors. Josiah Love knocks down a three.
That's a big shot now, and here comes APA. So quickly, we're finding some offense that we couldn't find last night, and Josiah had a quiet game last night, and he wants to bounce back along with Corbin. And here's the ball right now in the hands of Settlemeyer. Now over to, I believe that is Finley. And now we have Nave with it at the top.
Warriors starting out in a man-to-man switching defense.
That's a double dribble, and they got it. Turnover for APA, and right back over to the Warriors. Really didn't see, when we were in that man-to-man, we haven't seen any pressure yet, but I noticed that it still wasn't very comfortable for that APA offense against that switching man. So that might be something to watch. Warriors going after it now offensively, and they turn it right back over to APA on a little miscommunication between our guards. So see what they do. They're probably going to stay in the switching man-to-man here for a little bit. Hoping to stay out of foul trouble tonight. That seemed to be the root of all our problems early and caused it, I think, to really factor later in the game when we couldn't get any consistency. Here's a steal. Pretorius has it. And they got a travel on Pretorius. Probably should have went right up with that one.
That's what Coach McLaughlin was just telling too, right there. Just go up with your left hand right off the bat. He had him on his back hip.
Nave will bring it across for Anderson Prep. Corey Scott, their coach. He's been around Delaware County before, and he's calling out a set here. Nave having some trouble with it. Trey Adams up to pressure. Ball's loose. Found inside. A little shot fake up. Basket's off. Rebound. Still off, and it looks like it's going to be Warrior basketball. APA may be 0-12, but when you're playing a team like this, you've been in these games. They're scrappy, they play hard, and that can be scary.
Well, and you said you just have nothing to lose. You're looking for wins. You're just competing every night. Great take by Trey Adams right there. It was blocked, but kept the ball alive.
Pretorius thought about it. Again, we're just not sharp with the ball. And that's not an unforced turnover. That's just sloppy basketball on our part. And that basket's by number 32. I believe that's Zayden Finley, the 6'3 junior. We got to take care of the ball a little bit better, Coach.
Yeah, especially around the perimeter. You don't want to have turnovers.
Looks like we got our first foul call. It's going to be an out of bounds here, so it's non-shooting foul. See who this is on. That's going to be the first one on Ben Scott. Here's Pretorius from the corner on the inbounds. It's off. Good positioning by Price, but the ball squirts out to Nave, and he has it across for APA. APA will try to get set in something. A lot of off the dribble right now. And there it is again, and that is Finley, who has both their baskets right now. Adams thought about it. Now it's to Pretorius for three. It's his second attempt, and it's his second miss. Rebound to Scott. And so I'd like to see us go inside a little bit more and attack instead of settling for the three. Establish the inside and then let the outside come.
Yeah, and you got to move the ball a little bit. Obviously, Corbin Price in the high post, I'm sure, is on the scouting report. It's not going to be there off of one or two passes.
That might have been a travel. But
checking in for Wes-Del, number 14.
I believe that was number 34, Caleb Eldridge scoring. So right now the Warriors down 6-3, Probably not the start Coach McLaughlin's looking for. We're trying to bounce back here. Jacob Grant in the ball game, an early sub. Josiah's shot is off, rebound by Travis Bunch, and Bunch rebound put back is good.
Coach is making an adjustment here. We're going to see the Fury look, the 1-2-2.
And there's the steal. Back. Right out of it, Coach.
Corbin Price again.
I think this is the way we need to play right now. We need to get up and down and put some pressure on APA.
Yeah, you want to make them play, try to play faster than what they maybe want to.
Yep, it's a foul on Josiah Love. He got there a little late. And the other thing he did was he used the inside hand instead of the outside hand. And as coaches, we always try to stress that, but it doesn't always work. Lincoln Fathauer is now in the ballgame for APA. So Jacob Grant came in quick to relieve Cade Pretorius. I think Coach was talking about what we were talking about. He wants to see the ball go inside before we start shooting off a one pass. So I'll probably communicate that to Cade getting back in the game. It's going to be a travel, and there's been, I unofficially, third turnover, I believe, for the Warriors. Am I correct down there, Coach Nuckols?
Yes, you're correct.
I knew I'd have it on the stats there. 7-6 lead for the Warriors. Coach Nuckols doesn't miss them. If you're playing at home, you're going to have to keep good stats. And there's a deflection. And as we know, that's important in our off, or excuse me, in our defense. That's something we stress. Is Coach wants as many deflections, he tracks them. So that's good. A lot going on tonight. I'm struggling to keep my attention. There's so much happening.
It's good to see all the little ones.
Yeah.
They're all over.
They're ready for that cheerleading. Backside trying to drop here. Nice little dump down, and that's going to be a score by Nave, number 10. Xavier Nave gets on the board with a bucket, and it's 8-7 Anderson Prep. Stripped away there, Josiah Love, and it's into the hands of Ben Scott, and he'll bring it across. Three on the way, and it's good. Lincoln Fathauer with a three. And APA having no trouble scoring early. That's a good take. I'll take that take from Josiah Love more than that floater. And Corbin Price cleans it up. I think we've all thought, you know, we want Love to be a little more aggressive, and we saw it there. This thing is moving at a pace I don't know that you and I were ready for, Coach Hanson.
No, it's going to be quick. It's going to be up and down, which
Love with two.
Josiah's doing a great job early on here against the zone, looking to attack.
Right now, they're going to hit their offensive averages by halftime. That one a little off there. Here come the Warriors. Josiah Love has it. Looking to attack. Floater on the way. A little short. We're going to get a foul here on Corbin Price or Jacob Grant. I think it might be Jacob Grant. Yeah, it's going to be Jacob Grant there.
Let's go foul on number 14, Jacob Grant.
Substitutions in the ball game all over the place. Grayson Mealy replacing Travis Bunch, and Jack Rooker taking over for Corbin Price. In for APA will be number 20, Settlemyer, coming back in the game. They're going to extend this. They've got Rooker with some size on the top. And right away they get a steal out of it. Here's Trey Adams, little bounce pass. Doesn't work out. They're going to get a reach on 32. That'll be Finley, I believe.
ADA foul on number 32, Zayden Finley.
That'll be his first.
Yeah, I'm already winded. I didn't expect this pace. Bounce pass inside, or excuse me, inbounds pass into Rooker. He missed it. And here come the Jets. That's turned over, and now we're going the other way. Into Trey Adams, and it's up, off, and out of bounds off of, I thought that might have been off of Jacob Grant, but the officials say it's going to stay here with the Warriors.
Got a quick pace here.
Yeah. I find Josiah Love sneaks in there, and he hits a jumper.
Good to see Josiah getting off to a quick start tonight.
They got a hand check here. This is Jacob Grant. It's his second. I think it's either him or Trey Adams. That's going to be Trey Adams, so should be his first.
Let's go foul on number 30, Trey Adams. Ben Scott back in the game for Anderson Brett.
13-11, 1:52 to go, Warriors lead. They're going to get Grayson Mealy here, I think. No. There is no 24. There is no 24. They gave it to the wrong guy. He struggled there. His mind was still on that mustache.
Correction, Wes-Del foul number 34, Grayson Mealy.
Good trap up that top there.
Should get a turnover. There we go. Jacob Grant will take it, and one. A nice take by Jacob Grant. Like to see that. 32, that's going to be the second, I believe, on Finley. That's tough for them because right now Finley is their leading scorer. Pretorius now after coming out is going to get Trey Adams. I believe they talked to Cade a little bit about not settling for the three too early. Jacob Grant's free throw on the way, and it's off. 15-11, 1:33 to go in the first quarter. There's Finley. He is playing with two fouls. And that went off and knocked away there by Fathauer. And inside to Scott. Scott misses. Scott fighting for it. They're going to call Jack Rooker on a hold.
Wes-Del foul on number 20, Jack Rooker.
Sure. I don't know that I saw that, but. And listen, I am at least 45 yards away and had a great look at that one. I don't know what's going on now.
I think there's a question on the foul before that.
I don't think these officials were ready for the pace. This could be an opportunity. No, we're going to get it. I just feel like somebody I hit pause. Hit pause, give me a second.
Yeah, regroup.
Let me get back into this thing. There's a lot happening.
Well, I think they called in the time before that. We had it up here as a second foul on Finley, but they called it on 42. And on the board says 42, but 42 is not Finley. Finley is 32.
Keep it high, Jack. Got to keep it high. It's all right. Got a shooting foul here.
NBA foul number 34, Caleb Eldridge.
You know, I don't know if the official underneath didn't see it or if.
I like this. Look at this. Some of us old school guys really like that right there. The kid just dropped the ball and he said no. He caught him over there and made him pick it up and give it to him.
I was more caught up in if this guy's offended that Super Trooper over here is taking all the calls. I don't know. You know, they don't work in crews anymore. They work in assigners, so they're. They're all being assigned differently, and I don't know how I feel about it. But no one cares what I think, even my wife. 55 seconds to go. It's 16-11. Wes-Del leading. And that one's off, and jump ball, no. Loose ball, yes. Pretorius has it. A lot of contact, but we're going to let him play. Josiah Love, nice little fake. Nice drive inside. He's struggling to hit that. He's had some good looks at it. Coach, he's just struggling.
Yeah, that was another great look right there. Warriors staying with the Fury.
Ben Scott, that one knocked out by Love. So good defense after the missed layup. So 22.3 left in the first quarter. It's been a little hectic pace. 16-11. And that's Fathauer for three, and in and out, and rebounded by Grayson Mealy. He gets it knocked out of bounds, and now they're going to get Grayson Mealy for a push. That'll be two on Mealy, so he'll see the bench for a while, probably the whole second quarter.
Travis Bunch checks in for Wes-Del.
Travis Bunch in to replace Mealy. 14.9 to go. And that one swatted away by Rooker. The ball's loose, still in the hands of APA now. They've got eight on the clock. A little behind the back. Doesn't work in traffic. Got to shoot it. And he lets it go and just missed it.
After one hectic quarter,
it's 16-11. Wes-Del leads. You're watching Wes-Del Varsity Boys Basketball on the Wes-Del Sports Network.
This is your IHSAA. This is your state. This is your high school. This is your athletic association.
Fans, I'm IHSA Commissioner Paul Knighty, and we're here to make sure that all of this remains yours.
This is your state. This is your community. This is your IHSAA.
Welcome back to Wes-Del High School Richard E. Johnson Gymnasium. Speaking of Richard E. Johnson, he is part of the inaugural Hall of Fame, the Athletic Hall of Fame class here at Wes-Del. Just started in 2022. First class went in this past fall, honoring them tonight. And former principal Richard E. Johnson was inducted in that class. We'll get to see more of them in halftime. So quick turnover there by APA here to start the second quarter. First half stats, Coach Nuckols, what do you have?
Yeah, we talked. I know Josiah Love's shot wasn't quite falling. He led the way with 7 points on 3 of 8 shooting. For Anderson Prep, it was Aiden Finley with 4, which I know he got in foul trouble there early on, so him being out may help us here.
There you hear it. Your stats provided by Coach Hanson and the baseball team. These are sponsored tonight for your in-game stats. Speaking of which, how are workouts going?
Great. We're going twice a week, Tuesdays and Thursdays, so really good. We had about, I think, 11 last week. Just our high school numbers are down a little bit this year. I think I'm anticipating about 15, but.
As long as you got the right 15.
That's exactly right. So we've got a good group of great kids, and they're really, really working. So
well, that's good. I know I've got an excited one for baseball season at home. He's looking forward to it. So here are the Warriors with it. Trey Adams at the top of the key, getting the Warriors into their offense. Are we still seeing a zone look from APA, Coach?
Yes, they're still in their 2-3. They kind of have a little, their guards up top are a little staggered at the start of it.
Here comes Bunch, who you always wonder, will this be the time they get him for an illegal? Here's Pretorius, get in there. And he got it.
Good.
Cade Pretorius with the three and the trifecta, as Coach Wilson would say. It's 19-11 now. And we got a kicked ball. Coach Hanson, you've got one or two involved in the cheerleading.
Well,
does Coach
two.
Nuckols have one?
Not tonight.
Okay. He is trying to make sure he gets her to be a sport-specific athlete and not a cheerleader. Not that cheerleading isn't a sport. Josiah Love scores there, so all those cheerleading debaters out there, don't.
Anderson Pratt takes a 30-second timeout.
We're having some technical difficulties with your – we can say it. Your microphone, or you can't hear anything? I shut it off. No, I'm just kidding. Having some technical difficulties, Mr. Producer, with Mr. Nuckols. We're going to stay with you on this timeout and fix our technical difficulties. Coach Nuckols, if you can't see, what you can't see is at home. He was waving me down, telling me something, and I can't multitask. Why would he do that to me? I tried to turn him off because... Oh, now, there? No? I feel like we're doing a heck of a lot of work for a guy who only talks about five minutes an entire game. Got it? Nah, he's not worth it.
Try what they always tell me with technology. Just turn it off, turn it back on.
I think at this point we're giving him way more effort than he deserves.
I tried it.
Is your microphone working?
I think it's the headset.
Check, check.
Yeah, it's working. Unfortunately, we still can hear him.
He can talk.
Here we go. APA trying to attack here. Ooh, almost looked like Travis Bunch wanted to take a charge there. Now we've got a foul. And with a couple of quick moves of the wire, unplug it, blow on it, and Mr. Romine got it working again. In the meantime, who got that foul?
That was Corbin Price, and it's his second.
Corbin Price with his second foul.
This will be, looks like, second night where Corbin is going to see.
Yeah, and Jacob Grant's going to come back in replacing Price. So here we are, another evening of foul trouble. See how that plays out with a 21-12 lead. Number 20 right now, Settlemeyer hits the – I think he hit two there, didn't he?
Yeah.
Oh, fans at home, I'm sorry. We're trying to catch up. Inside to Josiah Love, and it's quick turnaround, up and in. Again, seeing good things out of Love early. Keep this thing going. There's a steal by Bunch. I don't know. I don't know what happened. And here's a long pass into Scott. Scott in traffic, and he banks it in.
Ben Scott.
Here's Adams looking against the zone to find either a dribble to the seam. Here's a three on the way from Pretorius. It's off the front edge and into the hands of Fathauer, who will bring it across, and he'll pitch it over to number 23, Samar Nave. Ooh. He wanted to double dribble there, but that went inside, knocked away by Travis Bunch, and here comes Pretorius. Kate trying to find some room now out to Grant, and Grant will set it back up. Here's Trey Adams on the drive. Dump down, nice pass. Josiah's just cannot, and again, and finally.
Travis Bunch.
That's a play we specifically run for Travis Bunch. It's called offensive rebound. If you get it, shoot it. That went off and into the hands of Jacob Grant, and a technical has been called on, I believe, Ben Scott. It is on 24, Ben Scott. I don't know. He hit... There was a jump shot.
I thought he was mad at himself. I didn't really see what happened.
There was a jump shot. I don't know. I think he clapped his hands together. He may. I'm speculating here, but he may have made a comment about the mustache. Some people are sensitive. Listen, they're back. Mustaches are back. I don't know what happened, folks. That was a quick one, though.
Yeah, it was. Like I said, I must have missed out. Well, then again, we
he
could have
cussed.
Don't know what
I mean,
said.
Let's be honest. Yeah. There could have been language.
Yeah.
We weren't down there. I was speculating. It was a nice play, and Love's in a little bit of trouble. Back out. Swings it to Grant now. Nice pass inside. Jacob Grant to Josiah Love, and there's two, and it's 29-15. I like the offense tonight. Moving the ball well. Oh, this is not going to be good. There's going to have to be a voice of reason, and I don't see one down there right now.
I didn't see that one either, though.
I didn't see it either. I think Corey Scott's got an argument. Anyway, back to the Warriors. And they will try to, again, keep working against this APA zone. Moving the ball is a good thing. Trey Adams gets it quick. It's off. Travis Bunch inside there. He's always poking it around, making something happen. Couldn't make that one out back into the hands of APA. 23 with it. Quick shot.
Good rebound by Travis. Warriors looking to push again.
I appreciate you stepping in there. I was almost out of air. They're going to find the AED.
Everybody likes listening to you.
I don't think so.
Oh, probably nice pass.
That is a great pass.
And a great cut, too. Josiah didn't stay in the corner right there. Did a great job when he tacked to cut there to the block.
And that's one thing we always talked about when we were down there at practice, when I was helping out, was especially a drive to the middle. Nice. I thought that was going to go. Travis Bunch with a great rebound. Drive to the middle against the zone. Don't stand. When they get to the middle, especially that what they call, that's a travel on Cade Pretorius. They call that the Kenny the Jet Smith baseline cut. He was great at it, but whenever you get the drive, and we got a timeout here, it's going to be a full. Whenever you get that drive to the center of the court, don't stand and watch, cut. Where you got a full timeout, we're going to take a quick break here on the Wes-Del Sports Network. You're watching Wes-Del Varsity Basketball.
Are you looking for a professional home improvement business in Muncie, Indiana? Call Property Pros. Remodeling, landscaping, electrical, you name it, we can help. Our team cares about your home just as much as you. We are quick and efficient with our work. We are your one call for all your residential and commercial home repair, remodel, and maintenance needs. We've got the best team around with decades of talent and expertise. Give us a call today to schedule your professionals to complete your project.
And we're back here. 31-15, Wes-Del leading this one and extending this lead, hoping to extend it even further. We've got Rooker, Adams, Grant, Love, and Pretorius on the floor. A little bit of foul trouble. Price and Mealy, shocking, no. Both of them have been in foul trouble before. So we've learned to play this way before with a little shorthanded. 3:36 to go. APA going against now the trapping pressure. That is knocked away by Jack Rooker. It's going to stay with APA. Corey Scott being assisted by another Delaware County former head coach, Mike King. Mike King used to be at Cowan, and that was Nave with the basket. And Corey Scott was at Daleville. Now both together on the sidelines at APA. Pretorius has it over to Adams now. Back to Pretorius, trying to get it in, looking in at Jack Rooker. Here's Grant for three. Off and a long rebound, and it's into the hands of APA number 34, Caleb Eldridge. There's Nave with it. He's got it over. And that is I will say that's a nice little move by Zayden Finley.
He'll shoot the bonus.
And he's got the and one. Rooker's second, I believe.
Athletic Hall of Fame inductees, please report to the cafeteria at this time. Athletic Hall of Fame inductees, please report to the cafeteria. You're looking for
Corbin Price re-enters the ball game here with two. Be a big 2 minutes and 53 seconds for him.
Yeah, I'm sure they had a conversation with him. See if he can, you know, you got to trust your junior here. That's into Love, another quick jumper, and that seems to be working right now. They're leaving that middle of that zone open for just enough time for them to hit Josiah, and he's turning right around and getting a jump shot out of it. Right back at him. And that was Finley, and then the rebound, Jacob Grant is pushing the ball. Pretorius sets his feet, fires. It's short. Corbin Price, and that's going to be a shooting foul. I believe he was going with a putback.
Yeah, it should be. I don't know. They called it out on the
They're going to call it out of bounds, but it needs to be a shooting foul.
APA foul number 10, Xavier Nave.
Everybody is going to the free throw line. So.
Yeah.
Corbin Price will shoot two.
Well, they're going to call it a one-on-one, so whatever.
He will shoot one in bonus.
Not sure that's exactly how that one should be scored, but as the people that have watched consistently know, I am a supporter of the Stripes. Nice rebound there by Trey Adams.
Yeah, Trey Adams was in the bottom block, used his speed, got around the bottom guy, and was able to put it up for two.
What are you doing tonight? Going root beer over Mountain Dew? You on a diet?
Well, you know, it's been a few weeks here since we really had a good discussion, but I have not had a Mountain Dew in a while.
Really?
Yeah.
As the CEO called you and told you sales are down?
Yeah. Yeah, it is. I'm sure.
So you're going no caffeine, I take it? Is that the plan?
Well, I
do you have a
cutting
plan?
Cutting back. I'm doing
cutting back to Dr. sarsaparilla, I see.
Dr. Pepper Zero and occasional root beer.
I think it's a good plan. In the meantime, Warriors have it, 35-20 lead. Well, I'm sure we'll have more time to catch up with your newfound soda diet. Pretorius driving. Are you going to write a book, by the way?
No. Oh, wow.
Trey Adams a little hard with that one. He's in weights class, so I think it's starting to take effect.
Coach Nuckols is happy.
That one was a little strong.
Absolutely.
And here we are still running the Fury. Ooh, that might have been a couple of steps. But Jacob Grant is in there getting rebounds, I'm telling you.
He's doing a great job tonight.
And there is got that was like 20 fouls.
20 fouls and about 10 steps.
20 fouls that led to 19 steps. Did you ever think of just going to diet, dude?
I can't do diet, dude.
Oh. Yeah. You're the last true family man. Josiah Love, rebound, put back. He's got it going right now. What do we have over there unofficially, Coach Nuckols? Where's he?
Love is at 19 points.
Wow. He's having a night. He's on a mission. We got a foul called here. It's going to be on number four, Cade Pretorius. His first.
Caleb Eldridge will shoot two.
1:10 to go before halftime, before all the festivities. Cheerleading, elementary cheerleading, if you didn't tune in earlier, and the Hall of Fame inaugural class of 2022, we're taking in this fall, will be honored. So we'll have the cheerleaders, elementary cheerleaders first. I'll be talking to elementary principal Todd Reagan about all the happenings at Wes-Del Elementary, and then we'll take a look at the inaugural class of the Hall of Fame. Eldridge hits the first.
Jason Settlemyer checks back in for PBA.
And in comes Jason Settlemyer. Good positioning by Corbin Price. And now Pretorius has it. This I love. Nice look inside. That's a foul. You can't do that.
So. Foul on number 34, Caleb Eldridge.
Caleb Eldridge, that's his third, I think.
Trey Adams will shoot one in bonus.
Adams has got, should be double bonus, right? No? No, sorry. That's us. Nate Blaylock's going to get some time here, and I bet he gets Price.
Nope.
Jacob Grant. Thought maybe they'd get Price out. Not hope he didn't get a cheap foul. But Trey Adams has one more here at the line. 38-21, 53 seconds to go. You can see Athletic Director Kai Denny informing the voice, Coach Wilson, on all the festivities after Trey Adams hits that second free throw. All the festivities of halftime is what they're discussing. He's got a big job, Coach Wilson. He's got to announce everything. Ooh, Love could have got one there, but probably going to get one there.
Wes-Del foul on number 25, Josiah Love.
His second.
Caleb Eldridge will shoot two.
Travis Bunch will replace. I would assume he's getting Josiah Love. Subbing a ball handler for a ball handler there.
Folks, please remember at halftime we'll be honoring the inaugural class of the Wes-Del Athletic Hall of Fame.
Eldridge with the second one here. And he hits it.
So please stay in your seats as we
39-23. Warriors in control here, but the Warriors have been in control before, and there's a lot of time left in the second half, so let's hope we can keep this going. That one all the way through to Nate Blaylock, who stops and pops. And snipered after the shot. So Blaylock gets the shot. He's instant offense as soon as he hits the court. That one loose.
A lot of ball movement.
Back to Blaylock. Blaylock just filling the stat sheet before halftime. 41-23 on the big bucket by Blaylock. The Warriors lead here. We're going to take a quick break, get organized, and get ready for the elementary cheerleaders with the high school cheerleaders presenting, and then we'll talk all things Hall of Fame. But when we come back, we'll have elementary principal Todd Reagan with us, and we'll talk all things elementary at Wes-Del. We'll be back with you here shortly on the Wes-Del Sports Network. We'd like to welcome all of our Warrior fans here to halftime at Richard E. Johnson Gymnasium. A lot of activities going on. It is elementary night, so no better person to have here on our halftime than elementary principal Todd Reagan. Welcome to the broadcast. Welcome to the Wes-Del Sports Network. You've been on here before, I believe, haven't you? Or is this first time?
No, about a year ago at elementary night. Yes. So very happy to be back. Thanks for having me.
It's great to have you back. It's always great to know you're going to be back again. That always, when the contract says you have another year, that's always a plus.
Definitely a good sign.
Yeah. So let's talk about the elementary, some things you're really excited about. So I'm going to leave it up to you. You kind of guide us where you want to go. But I know tonight we have the elementary cheerleaders, but I know there's so many things going on at the elementary, and you've done a really nice job. Thankfully, we're so far out of COVID now, we can really get a lot of activities going. So what are some highlights you have down at the elementary?
Absolutely. Well, here at elementary night, first of all, the elementary choir tonight with Angel Williams, the director, did a fabulous job.
Fantastic.
Singing our national anthem. Really proud of those guys. They do a great job. Coming up here at halftime, we will have a lot of cheerleaders from the elementary school. They've been working really hard on their performance tonight, so we're excited about that. And also, it's archery season. I didn't know if you knew that.
I did not.
It is archery season. Wes-Del Elementary has one of the premier archery teams.
I did know that.
In the area. The season has started. It started last week with our first meet, and then we had a state qualifying meet today. And I do know that, I don't know all the results yet, but I know Ava Johnson and Carter Carmen came in second place in the elementary division today in the state qualifier meet. So that's really exciting.
That is fantastic.
Not easy to do. They do have some more meets coming up, and you can catch them at the elementary school. We've got some home and away meets coming up, so very excited about that.
And one thing that a lot of fans need to realize is there's very few schools that have archery. And it's a great program. It's a great program for even students who aren't involved in athletics in another aspect to get involved in a competition sport. When we talk small school, big opportunities, it starts at the feeder program, which is the Wes-Del Elementary, and you have a lot of opportunities down there. You just talked about a couple. The archery program being probably, as you said, one of the premier ones. But what else do you have on there that you're really excited about?
Well, robotics season is getting started now, too. We have several teams going this year, including an all-girls team, a couple other mixed-gender teams as well. They will start competing early next month, but we also have some scrimmages coming up this year with a couple of elementary schools nearby. Very excited about that. We have a lot of kids involved in that
program. And talking a little bit about robotics, and I've seen it. So they have a field that they call it. It's got the robots inside of it. And as they compete, there's different skill-based things that they have to do. Maybe it be pick up a block and move that block or put it into a container.
Yeah.
And they have to, the athletes or the robotics athletes have to build that robot to specifically do and program it to specifically do the task that they need. And then they run it.
So before they ever even get to that meet, they have to work together to put literally hundreds of pieces together to, like you said, build that robot, get it working, program it, and then they get to the meet where they do whatever obstacles that is assigned to do that.
Are these kids kindergarten through fifth grade, or is it only open to certain grade levels?
So it's upper elementary. We have third through fifth grade. The fourth and fifth participate in the meets themselves, but we do have some third grade teams. And this is something, too, that students get exposed to in our STEM class as well. So
you probably have the best elementary STEM educator in the state.
I don't think there's any question, hands down, Mr. Lamb, Mr. Science himself. Like you said, the best STEM teacher probably in the state of Indiana. We were actually very honored. Mr. Nuckols and I took him two weeks ago to Purdue University to present at the Indiana STEM Conference, where we were able to share a lot of the good things going on in STEM at the elementary school. Really neat part about that is we got questions from Fort Wayne Community Schools and IPS, two of the largest schools in the state. We're asking Wes-Del how we're incorporating STEM.
And the other thing I know about that is with your STEM, you've had several surrounding school districts who have come to visit you. I've been in those visits. They're impressed. They can't believe what's going on. A lot of our community don't realize all of those things that are going on. We'll take a quick shot of the Hall of Fame out there on the court as you see them. We got a little out of order there. I think I got some different information, but just giving them a quick look at the Hall of Fame members. I'll run through that list later, but we're getting ready for the elementary cheerleaders that are going to perform. But back to STEM, I don't think a lot of people realize you're close to being the only STEM certified elementary in East Central Indiana. The closest one that I know of right now in proximity of miles is Union City, and that's at the Ohio line. So, you know, you've worked really hard at that. What does that mean to you, and what does that mean to your building and everything, your students, to have that distinction of the first STEM certified Department of Ed school?
Yeah, so we're actually halfway through that process right now. The Department of Education is going to be doing a visit to our building soon to kind of check out everything in action. But I think for us, it's just one of those things. STEM and robotics and all of that's going to kind of be our niche. We want to be known for it at Wes-Del Elementary. We want our students to experience those things, and it starts in kindergarten. Kindergarten through fifth grade, they're coding, they're building robots, they're doing everything that really you find more at the middle or high school level at a lot of places. Going back to your talking about schools visiting, I know we had somebody visit once that said her sons were doing things in the 10th grade that our second graders are doing at Wes-Del Elementary in STEM.
That's impressive.
Yeah, that was quite a compliment also to Mr. Lamb. You know, what he's doing in that program down there is really astonishing.
And that program, just so you know, what are we in, our second full year?
It's our second full year, yeah.
And for those of you at home that don't know STEM, the acronym, it's Science, Technology, Engineering, and Math. But we do squeeze in the A. Now, not officially with the DOE do they say the A, but we put it in there. And an example of that was the choir.
Yeah.
And so that makes it STEAM with that arts in there.
Exactly. And a lot of people don't know two different things. One, as a small elementary school, we have five different specials area teachers that are fully licensed. You will not find that anywhere.
No.
But two, that whole group works together. They do school-wide project-based learning activities together. I know we did one before Thanksgiving with a Thanksgiving Day parade. I know we had a Christmas tree contest with cardboard. So they actually work together. So, yeah, the arts are pulled into that program as well.
And as we talk about all the exciting things, the key here is, I'm going to shift gears on you a little bit and throw a curveball to you, but the key here is what we do academically. And I know this for a fact, a lot of people don't understand where we're at on our iRead scores for our third graders and what people don't realize. So that's a big assessment for third grade. And you're all about early literacy. You're all about literacy all through. That's been one of your main, you know, missions and goals and visions for us.
Right.
So when you get into third grade iRead, I think I heard you say we're in a really different class when it comes to our passing rate at iRead. So talk a little about the iRead test, but also what that means for us.
Yeah, well, we had very good results last year. We were 5% above the state average, which was very nice. One of the highest scoring schools in the county. Now, what we say is we're happy, but we're never satisfied. And so we've still got some work to do, and we're still going to, I think, have some improvements this year. But really being able to focus on literacy instruction and having a highly qualified literacy teacher and coach in the elementary has been huge for us. She works with all the teachers, sees about 50 students a day. Our goal is to everybody leaves our school as a reader, because, as you know, if you can't read, it's going to be very difficult after elementary school.
And then, so what we talked about early, and then, you know, you've got kids walking out. The goal is to have them reading either at or above grade level, which we're doing a great job of. We've made tremendous strides in the last 3 years of getting them there, getting them reading above grade level. But then on top of that, we talk about archery, we talk about robotics, we talk about all the other programs that we have for our kids. And when we say small school, big opportunities, it does start at the elementary. It starts at that preschool, which you have inside your building as well. You have 22 kids involved in preschool. And at one time when we started preschool, we had started out with 8.
Yeah.
And now we've built it to where we have kids that are almost overflow. And then this year, you start the, you go a step further, you start the early learning center back down at the bank where the preschool, we say the bank, but it's now our building. Right. So you've got so many things going on. Now, I know this for a fact. Do you have any space in your elementary to do anymore?
I was going to say, the reason the Early Learning Academy is at the bank is because our building is...
You're busting. Stopped. You're busting at the seams.
We're using every possible space in that building and using it as good as we can.
Yes,
so.
Absolutely. In fact, I had an outside... we were doing some assessments with some engineers and architects, and the one thing they turned and said to me is, and you've heard this from parents, every room you can use for education is being used, and you've even taken the teacher's lounge away.
Yeah, so unfortunately... They don't have a lounge this year. We're using every space. SRO Carmen will attest to that as he works out of a literal closet. Yeah. So,
but a good problem to have, and that speaks of volumes for our transfer rate down at your building alone is 27%, which tells you that not only are our in-district kids getting it, but we have people that are driving to Wes-Del, and that needs to be said. We need to market that people are choosing Wes-Del and Wes-Del Elementary.
And we get a lot of calls each year to take tours and ask information. And so what we're going to do this April is we're actually going to do a new family slash potential new family information night. Anybody that wants to check out Wes-Del Elementary is going to be able to come here from me, hear from some teachers. We're going to tour the building and then have a chance to ask questions. We're going to have that on our Facebook page and our school website. So folks can RSVP for that if they're interested. But we'd really like to get a good crowd of people in to learn more about Wes-Del and see if that's going to be a good fit for them.
Absolutely. As you can see, we've got the elementary cheerleaders out there getting ready to perform a little dance. We're talking with elementary principal Todd Reagan. One big final thing, probably the most important thing we'll talk about. You brought a tradition to Wes-Del in kickball. So the fifth graders take on the faculty and staff. Yes. So as you go through our elementary, you get to watch that kickball game. And when it's your fifth grade year, it's your moment.
Absolutely. Yep. You get to play us in fifth grade. That's a fun tradition that I've actually done at three different schools now across the state. We have a lot of fun with that. We do always tell the kids there's no crying in kickball.
Yeah,
so
yeah, absolutely.
If you don't beat the staff, that's okay.
But
it's fun.
What has the score been?
Oh my!
On average, we don't mess around as a staff.
Yeah, I'm gonna say the average is probably in the 40s to the not quite the teens.
Yeah, yeah. So it's been
a little brutal.
Yeah, it's been dominating.
But a lot of fun. And I'll tell you what, at the end of it, everybody gets a snow cone either way.
That's right. So. Absolutely, snow cones are there. And we are so glad to have them. So a lot of great things happening. Anything else you'd like to add or say about Wes-Del Elementary or elementary night?
Yeah, no, we have a lot of fun coming here. It's fun being a part in a small school, being a part of things at the high school. Be neat if we were together as one building
someday.
Could
do a lot more.
Yeah, but any opportunity we can have at the elementary to come here to the middle high, we love it. That's always fun to do. I would just say that, again, to folks that are interested in Wes-Del or learning more about what we're doing, just check us out on our Facebook page. Check us out on Twitter or on the even on the school webpage. Lots of information will go on there. And again, information about our family information night that's coming up, as well as it's already time to think about kindergarten roundup.
I was just going to say, we're getting close.
coming up in early April, and information about that, again, is on all of those social media sites.
Well, I appreciate you stopping by. Always good to talk with you. I get to talk with you every day, but not the fans on the Wes-Del Sports Network.
This is true.
So appreciate that. It looks like Brian Lake's got a little cleanup to do out there with the pom-poms.
They got a little wild, but they had fun.
They did have fun.
They did a good job.
We appreciate you stopping by, and have a great evening. You're sticking around for the second half, right?
Stick around. We're doing great here. Looks like it's hopefully going to pull out for a win tonight.
We hope so. So good talking to you. That's Todd Reagan, Wes-Del Elementary principal. A lot of great things happening at Wes-Del Elementary. We've got about 3 minutes. It does see that Brian Lake has reached the floor. He's going to clean up a little bit, and we're going to take an extended audio break, but leave the video up. You're watching Wes-Del Varsity Basketball on Wes-Del Elementary Night here on the Wes-Del Sports Network. I want to welcome you back. It's just me. Everybody else is enjoying a nice extended break, Coach Nuckols and Coach Hanson. But I wanted to get on here and discuss the inaugural class of the 2022 Athletic Hall of Fame. Once again, Wes-Del Community Schools working with some donors that don't want to be mentioned, but they gave quite a bit of startup money to get our Hall of Fame started. And then organized by a board of directors that includes Mike Bush, Kay Carmichael Harrell, Bob Harrell, and Dave Land, and Eric DeBoard, and Kai Denny is also athletic director, and myself are on that board. So here's the inaugural class that we had out here on the floor tonight. We had Debbie Martin Barnes, who went in as an athlete for the class of 1976. Mary Helen Bink went in as a contributor from her time from 1982 to 2018. Teresa Seals' mom went in as an athlete of the class of 1976. Mike Bush in as a coach and contributor from 1978 to 2018. Kim Dudley Kane as an athlete for the class of 1977. Mike Davis as an athlete for the class of 1977. Eric DeBoard as an athlete for the class of 1977. Mike DeBoard, a class of 1974, he went in as an athlete. Eric Foster as an athlete in the class of 1986. Phil Gardner as an athlete in the class of 1968. Kay Carmichael Harrell as a coach from 1975-76 and 1986-87. Bob Harrell as a coach from 1975 to 1978. Fred Heron went in as an athlete, a 1967 graduate. John Hines, an athlete, a graduate of 1975. Sharon Jackson, an athlete, graduate of 1978. Brian Johnson, an athlete, a graduate of 1976. Mike Johnson, an athlete, graduate of 1985. Richard Johnson, contributor, the longtime principal from 1967 to 1994. Bobby Johnson is an athlete in the class of 1987. Karen McClurg-Jones is an athlete in the class of 1976. Dave Land is a coach from 1969 to 1975. Deborah McClurg is an athlete, graduate of 1979. Michelle Miller, an athlete, and the graduate of 1978. Paul Parker, the first superintendent of Wes-Del Community Schools. Back then, it was Harrison Washington. And he went in as a contributor for his role as a superintendent, but also, as you know, Paul Parker Field is named after him. A field in which we'll be getting some nice renovations here shortly. He is a contributor in 1964 to 1985. Bill Robertson, coach, 1975 to 2019. Kay Saunders, a coach and contributor, one of the first, if not the first, athletic directors as female in the state of Indiana, 1967-1994. This is also Kay Saunders Court. Sharon Unger, an athlete of 1979, and rounding out the inaugural class, Steve Yonce, athlete of 1970. And look, just in time, these two guys are back and we're playing basketball. I couldn't have timed it better. Mr. Producer had me set up perfectly. We're back to basketball. Great interview. You guys missed a lot. I hope you didn't sneak a Mountain Dew at halftime.
Oh, no. Nope. Got a good video, so it was really good. And Corbin Price starts it right there with getting to the middle of the zone for two. So great start for the Warriors.
I apologize. I had you turned up because Mr. Reagan is as loud as you. You're just a loud guy. Have you ever been told that?
Nope, never.
Here come the Warriors. Love attacking, and he scores, and it's going to be an and one. Love, you can tell that Josiah Love came here with a mission tonight. He did not like last night's outcome of, I believe he had 8 points.
Yeah, and he was in foul trouble, too, most of the night, so just really never got going. So you like that out of the sophomore. Really just kind of wanted to get back in the gym and make a statement tonight.
What's in the hospitality room tonight?
It was Arby's sandwiches, chips, and cookies.
Oh. Now I know where you guys were. Now I bet you had to do dad duty, didn't you?
I got some videos. I was watching the halftimes. All the cheerleaders.
It was good. It was a good performance. That was almost through for Ben Scott. Got a trap going on down low, and that's in the hands of Cade Pretorius. Here come the Warriors in transition. Corbin Price back in after some early foul trouble. It's been a theme.
Nice pass.
And Travis Bunch. I think Travis Bunch might be working on a career game. That's 6 points, I think. And my stats might be off, but if Travis gets to eight, we might be looking at a career game. Cade Pretorius now trying to handle it. Let's get it to Travis for a three. Josiah Love will take a three and just off and into the hands of Ben Scott. You don't think that's going to happen?
Well, I'd venture to say even if he was wide open, he probably wouldn't take it.
Well, he took one. He's shooting the best on the team. He made it. And he took two in that game. He's shooting 50%.
Well, percentage so. Would say shoot another one.
That's what he says. Coach Nuckols is there. Coach Nuckols, let's just say what it is. I turned you off. Do you have some stats down there? You're eager to do something. Give us some stats.
Yeah, we talked about how Love was having a good first half. I know he picked up his second foul there before the halftime, but he's up to 22 points. Travis Bunch is at 6 points. He also has
Hang on. Oh.
He was going for eight.
We're going to a career game for Travis Bunch. I'm his biggest fan. I want to see it happen. I think they should run straight for Travis right here for a three. They didn't do it. What do you got? You got anything else? Is that all you got to add tonight?
Trey Adams also had a good first half. He had seven assists in the first half, 6 points. So he's a quiet game, but big producer.
What's the game look like down there on the floor? Is it a lot bigger and faster?
Yeah, everybody's a little bit taller here on the floor than they look up from up top.
They know we're lying. That's a nice pass and score there by Fathauer inside, and it's 48-27, 5:30 to go. Still in the zone, Coach.
Yeah, APA staying in their 2-3 zone. Good ball movement for the Warriors here start to half. So, as you see, Corbin Price really and Travis working good inside. And
Corbin Price has got the official's eye. But I got to be honest with you, he's not real thrilled with the contact he's getting from – I don't know if that's 43, Connor Ring. Yeah, it's 43, but it's 41 on the roster. But if we ever get a roster that's right this year, it'll be amazing. And that, I told you on the last one, and Coach McLaughlin's telling him that. I told you just now that Corbin Price was working inside there. He's getting frustrated, and they got him. I'm sure Coach told him that the official was looking at you last time. And you went in and did. But he gets it back, he gets a steal, and he lays it in. So now he'll probably get some praise for, and there's a turnover by APA. And he does. He gets a high five from Coach. Best way to make up for a mistake, steal the ball and lay it in.
Yeah, exactly. And it's going to lead to a Jets timeout here.
Got a timeout. It's going to be a 30-second timeout. We'll stay with you because we're going to stay with you because I worked my butt off at halftime and these guys didn't do anything. So We're going to let them add some more things. You got anything down there, Coach Nuckols?
Okay. Yeah, for the Jets, Finley's still leading the way with 9 points. I know he set a little bit of that first half, but it looks like him being back is going to help them out here. And for the Warriors in the first half, something we didn't talk about a lot was Jacob Grant. He had a big first half with 6 assists and 4 rebounds and a few points.
Yeah, hey. I thought Jacob Grant played a great first half.
He had a good
half.
One. Well, the cheerleaders are in it now. This is the church clap dance. Got to be honest with you, I don't get it, but I'm also in my 40s, so my son will tell you I don't get anything.
Well, and he's back in the game, too. I don't know if we mentioned
that. He'll get a foul. That's what he'll get. I can tell you that much. Okay, Pretorius has it. Now into the hands of Trey Adams. Warriors 50-27 lead. Little double screen. Pretorius got it. Got a double screen there from Price and Mealy, and that's what you do. You screen the top of that zone. And I'm going to tell you right now, there are a lot of people that are upset with Connor Ring. He's a physical kid, and there's a lot of shoving. That time it was Trey Adams. I don't think he's meaning to be vicious. He's just a pretty strong kid who's banging around in there. And I don't think we saw him in the first half. Oh, my. They're going to see if that – oh, they're going to say it's off of Mealy. He's not going to miss that one.
Warriors are in a man-to-man. Come out of the Fury for the set underneath.
Ben Scott, the coach's son, you can see that in him. He's got some knowledge. And they're trying to up the game a little bit. Pretorius looking baseline. He got, a lot of contact. Great rebound and put back by Corbin Price. Did you think he got, I thought he got a lot of contact.
Yeah, it definitely looked like it.
And it's 55-29, now 4 minutes to go. And now it's stolen. Here's Corbin Price on the fast break. And a lot of contact there is going to be a foul. He's claiming he got all ball, but. He might have got half an arm and a shoulder with the ball.
Zayden Finley.
Coach Nuckols, speaking football-wise, some exciting things coming up. We had a good call-out numbers. I think you had several more kids at the call-out this year, right?
Oh, absolutely. We had about 65 kids from our 6th up to our 11th grade, which is really good. Looking at hopefully about 10 a class, which would put us, you know, around that 35-40 range in the high school. That'd be fantastic.
And big facility upgrades coming down the pike too, and it's exciting. We're going to see Paul L. Parker Field get an overhaul along with the track for our track athletes, and that's a positive. That's a good thing, and I'm sure that's brought some numbers up too. That knocked away by Mealy, and it's in the hands. Nice move there by Trey Adams. That's knocked out. So. Exciting things. I like the schedule next year, too. We're going to have a little tweak in the schedule. Is this one more year of MEC, or are we out of MEC play now?
No, we're officially out of it. So our schedule is going to look a lot different. I think we picked up 5 new teams that we either haven't played in the past or it's been a handful of years here. So a lot of good things coming.
It is, and we got a charge here maybe, looking back at the action. We do. Fathauer, who took the charge?
Jack Rooker.
Holy moly, it's a Christmas miracle. Oh, I hope Jack watches again. Let's me know. I'm proud of you, Jack. Been asking for that for about 19 years. He's not even 16. So Rooker gets the charge. I like to give Jack a little bit of heart. Ooh, we're getting a hand check now. I don't know what we're doing here. Fathauer with that one. That's going to be his second, I believe. Anyway, 57-29, 3:26 to go. Ooh, I almost thought Cade was going to get called for travel right there. Official was looking at him kind of like, eh. Not saying he did, just thought he was going to get called for one. Rooker.
Good screen there.
Nice dump down. That one's loose. And into the hands of Ben Scott. Ben Scott will attack, and he's going to get a wide open layup there. He got split right between two defenders at the top and scored it. Reminder this year, the Warriors, oh, nice fake by Trey Adams. Warriors are in 2A, so they will be playing, I believe they've said the host site for basketball is Monroe Central. And be going to the Golden Bears land. And I believe it's Winchester, Frankton, Wapahani. Kate Pretorius stop and pop, and he hits it, but that was just inside the three-point line.
I believe Frankton actually is up in 3A, actually, out of that
are
sectional.
They?
Yes.
Now that's a good thing.
Yeah.
I'll take it. That's a miss there by number 32, Finley. That one's loose into the Trey Adams' hands. Trey Adams, they're going to get Fathauer for a hand check. That's going to be his third. Yeah, I'm trying to think. Is LaPel 2A?
Yes, yeah. I think LaPel's in it.
Well, that's not good. Winchester's decent this year. Monroe Central, you know, they're always scary. You've got Wapahani in there. That's a tough one. So it wasn't a good, you know, move to a 2A for us. But we'll deal with it. Skip pass to Pretorius. He thought about it. He steps in and buries it. I like that. I like that.
That was good.
You notice that Coach Brody took him out in the first half, talked to him about not settling for that. And I really think Cade's made a nice job of adjusting and doing what Coach said. Might have been a kick ball there, but see what Jack's going to do with it. And it's an and one. Foul was on Connor Ring. You got a day of rest tomorrow after this doubleheader. You got an easy day?
Oh, no. No, no.
There's no rest days for the Hansons.
No rest. We, day of church, and then I'll be here for the youth baseball fundraiser. We're selling hot dogs.
I'll come out and get a hot dog and support the Wes-Del baseball program. Hot dogs, inflation, what are they, $7 a dog?
Nope. Still there. We do hot dogs are $3 or a meal for $5. Ooh. Chips and a drink.
That's a deal.
So, and a lot of, be a lot of teams.
Yeah, there are a lot of teams. Probably a good fundraiser.
Yeah.
Yeah. So there you go. Don't forget, if you're driving by and you're like, you know what I need? I need right now, I need to go in and be around 180 second through sixth graders and just to get a hot dog. If you're in that mood, stop by Wes-Del High School, come inside, stop by the booth and get a hot dog. All the fixings, relish and everything?
We'll be glad to see you, absolutely.
It gets everything. Come out and support. I don't even know what I'm doing here trying to keep up. Finley with the basket. Come support Wes-Del Baseball and get a dog. Hey, that's a great fundraiser if you think about it. When you go to a baseball game, that's what you want. You want a hot dog. I mean, that's typically. So what a great way to stay in the theme. Finley knocks that one away from Rooker. Minute 3 to go. It is a 30-point lead for Wes-Del. Remember, 35 points, the clock will run. So, and it will never stop. And only on fouls, free throws, and, you know, that stuff. Rooker baseline drive. Nice take. Stay with it. Back up, and he's good.
Good strong move there by Jack.
44 seconds to go. It's a nice lead for the Warriors. Blaylock's in. They're going to get Grayson Mealy on that one because he got in the vicinity of someone else, and usually that constitutes a foul. 34. That official, I haven't been nice to him tonight, but I'm not being terribly mean, but I would call the way he walked over here lumbering. He may be tired. Fathauer coming back in. He's going to replace Ben Scott. Mealy's got three. Chances he fouls out right now. Vegas stats have it high. If you're a betting man, I'd go all in on Mealy fouling out. Push all your chips in. Nice little jump shot there. It's off. Rebound to Jack Rooker. 30 seconds to go in the third. Warriors with a commanding 32-point lead. We'll get some stats here at the break. So get ready over there, sideline reporter.
He was born ready.
Oh, yeah. Listen, he crunches these numbers. All these numbers and stats are done on a Casio watch. One's off, and Corey Scott wanted a foul. We're going to take a quick audio break here at the quarter, and we'll come back, get some stats from Coach Nuckols, and have the fourth quarter of action. You're watching Wes-Del Boys Basketball on the Wes-Del Sports Network.
You're good. This is your IHSAA. This is your state. This is your high school. This is your athletic association.
Fans, I'm IHSA Commissioner Paul Knighty, and we're here to make sure that all of this remains yours.
This is your state. This is your community. This is your IHSAA.
Hang on, I want to see if I won the raffle.
5-7.
What was it?
5-4-5.
5-5-5.
7.
I had a 6. I was trying to see if I was going to stay here or go home and be rich.
5-4-5. 5-5.
All right, got some notes here from Coach Hanson. Oh, we've got some wrestling winners today. Malachi DuBois. And Luke Powers, they won the Mideastern Conference. They were champions?
Yep, they were in the weight class today. So,
that's fantastic.
Yeah, congratulations to those guys.
Congratulations to Luke Powers and Malachi DuBois on the championship as a conference wrestler. Josiah Love, don't leave him alone. Look at Travis. Get in there. Stay with it, Travis.
In the old school 21, though, he was going for the put out.
Yeah, he was. He was. I need double digits out of – I need – right now. They don't take him out. I need double digits out of Travis Bunch tonight. I have him on my fantasy basketball team. Blaylock, Bunch, Adams, Love, and Price. What is that guy? That guy is getting – is he okay? What was that? This guy's got a bench warning. He's.
Folks, if you want to watch big TV, Danny Cairns is the winner. Danny Cairns is your winner.
Danny Cairns won the TV. There you go. Nice shot, basket by Fathauer. There was a bench warning to the APA bench. I don't know what was said, but it's a 30-point lead for the Warriors. Trey Adams, nice little jumper on the way. It's off. Corbin Price, rebound put back. Warriors extend it to 32. I don't know what we'll have after the game. Might have a couple players come up. We'll wait and see. Nice pass from Josiah Love to Trey Adams. That's two more. And it is 69. Yeah, 69. Yeah, 35. They had to put it on the board a little late. Don't question Keith Roberts. That one's going to stay with APA.
Folks, the Mideastern Conference had its annual wrestling championship today. Wes-Del had two champions, Luke Powers.
Making the announcement about Luke Powers and Malachi.
Your AAC Conference wrestling champions.
Three Three on the way, and it's off. Rebound back out. Trams knocks that one out of bounds.
Also an NBC champion at the wrestling match today, Malachi Dubois.
And we knock it away again.
Congratulations to all the winners.
That's what you call deja vu. They knocked it away three times.
APA takes a full timeout.
And a full timeout. We're going to take a quick one here. You're watching the Wes-Del Sports Network.
Looking for high-quality fuel and tasty food on the go in Gaston? Look no further than Johnson's Oil. We are a family-run business that's been serving the local community for generations. Our convenience store offers a wide range of snacks, drinks, and other essentials, as well as delicious food, fish, chicken, tenderloins, and potato wedges. We're committed to supporting the local economy by hiring Wes-Del students and Gaston residents. Come visit us at Johnson Oil.
And we're back. Band sounds good tonight. Is that the final countdown? Well, it might have been a little early. 6:21 to go. And I wish it was the final countdown, but I feel like there'll be a few more stoppages in play. I wonder, everyone always, when you hear final countdown, you always ask yourself, I know I do, what happened to Europe? Just me?
Yeah, that's a good point. Oh, my.
That's got to be a charge. That's a terrible call. But yeah. Hey, but when they're up by 34, I'd probably call block two.
Yeah, that's clearly a charge.
Yes.
Travis, I don't think Travis moved from the time the ball was inbounded.
He didn't. And just as shocking as last night was that Grayson Mealy got his first foul in the third quarter. That's the first foul on Travis Bunch with 6:19 to go in the fourth quarter. So we'd like to congratulate Travis. That is a new record. When he watches this over, congratulations, Travis. You made it almost a full game without fouling. That one's off and a player down, and he does not look like he's getting up quickly. I think he rolled his ankle.
It's a set of Honda keys.
And Blaylock talking to him about falling down. Blaylock knows everything about that. He did that right before halftime. Four slick. Not really, but nice block out by Travis, and it's going to stay there. That was off of an APA cheerleader, but they're going
to
remain here.
To a Honda car. It was auto-started. I'm sure it'll shut off. But I've got them right down here.
Uh-oh. There's a Honda keys down there with Coach Wilson. If they don't claim it by the end of the night, it's going to Coach Wilson. It is.
And it's already started.
Yeah, he hit
nice
the auto-start button. So, folks, if that's your car, the heated seats are on. That kid took off. It's a new rule. I hate it. It's a new rule, but you're supposed to dribble. I've never been for it. 5:59 to go. We have not met the requirement for 35 points for a running clock.
Latarius Stevens checks in for Anderson Prep.
And Warriors bring it across to half court. That's Trey Adams. Gets it to Corbin Price, screened by Travis Bunch. Back to nice little drive there by Josiah Love. And we'll do a quick sideline check-in. How many is Josiah at now, Coach Nuckols?
Love's up to 24 points.
That's a pretty good night. 71-36, Warriors exceeding their offensive output. Again, they're only averaging 54 a night.
Well, the good thing is, Matt, like tonight, that helps that out.
Yeah, get a lot of averages going. We're going to get a foul here and an and one. Fathauer hits the bucket. I'm going to say Blaylock here.
He'll shoot the bonus.
Yep. Nate Blaylock.
Number 40, Nate Blaylock.
That's his first. We got a plethora of subs. Jacob Grant, Jack Rooker, Cade Pretorius replacing Bunch, Price, and Adams.
Jack Rooker and Cade Pretorius.
That one's off, and Jacob Grant, who's been rebounding and doing a little bit of everything. We said he had six assists in the first half. That's to Blaylock. Thought he was going to pull that one.
Good
ball. Nice little dump down. Just a little short.
Really good ball movement right there.
And there's a three on the way. It's off. Rooker might have got away with a push in the back, but Jacob Grant lays it in. Nice pass from Kay Pretorius. And I believe now we've met the requirement, and the clock will run, unless my math is really bad. But it could be, because I went to a school just to the north. Colors are red and black, and they have a bear for a mascot, but I won't name them. And my math could be off. Oh, blocked there by Rooker. And that clock is running. So it should stop when they give him the ball, though, at the free throw line.
Caleb Eldridge will shoot two.
Some subs are going to come in for Anderson Prep. That's going to be number 42, Gavin Mitchell. And number 11, Devion Chapman.
Gavin Mitchell checks in for APA. Grayson Mealy returns for Wes-Del.
And Mealy's back in, so everybody get your Vegas. Check your line here. He's got three. He's got 4 minutes to go. He's got a rebound. No foul there. Rooker, they're going to swing it around, run a little offense here. Over to Love. Love on the baseline attack, and he scores. And they're going to call a block. I probably would have just let it go.
He'll shoot the bonus.
Basket was good. I will say this. If you watch college officials, they'll wait and see if that basket goes in a situation like that, and they'll just let that one go. People will argue that, but that's really, hey, it didn't impede the basket. The basket was made. And rebound to Mealy. Screens, Love lost it on the drive. Blaylock coming in. He's going to replace Josiah Love. That'll probably be it for Love. That was a good night for him, I think, officially 24. No, 26.
26.
26 officially. Good night. Good bounce back game for Josiah Love. I tell you what, the one thing you can count on elementary night is it'll get cooler in the gym later in the game because a lot of people take off after the performance at halftime. But you know what? You still get their dollars. Still get those ticket monies. It's good for the athletic department. It's good for the school. It's good for everybody. Coach, I hope that there's a steal by APA and knocked out of bounds by Kate. Good hustle. I hope that in my discussion of Mountain Dew, not knowing their situation, that I will not cause a relapse.
No, no. Well, hold strong. Getting ready for baseball season.
Yeah?
I got to get more
active. I've seen you. Listen, I've seen you in baseball pants, and I'm your number one fan for this Mountain Dew diet.
Well, you know, there's a lot of truth to that because I was not going to go on a – suits are not cheap.
No.
So
I was going to say, he changed pivot foot. No, suits are not cheap.
So it's getting
you wear a suit at third base?
No, just in general. So it's getting to the point where either figure it out or going to have to buy some more different clothes.
Yeah, well, my dad had a friend that said he wasn't fat, he just wore big clothes. Nice guy. Abdullah finds an opening in the seam. Shot goes up. We've got a lot of subs in. Sawyer Slopsima, Abdullah Mir. Tyler Summers. Oh, that's a charge. Oh! I wouldn't argue it. We're up by a lot.
Wes-Del foul on number 10,
you got to know the situation.
Correct, because that was a great play by Abdullah right there.
Yeah, you got to just take that one. If he watches this over, Abdullah, you've got it in our book. We got to know the situation. They're not going to give that to you when you're leading by. What do we got? 36? Yeah. Mr. Mr. Grog would be really upset with me on how long it takes me to tally up these numbers. There's a rebound by Mealy on the block out, and we're headed the other way. Summers has it over to Sawyer Slobsima. Some names that we, our JV guys, getting some younger guys in. Nice little pass back. Sawyer, that's Sawyer Slobsima. Now he's super excited about that. I think that might have been his first varsity points. So congratulations to Sawyer. Pumped the fist there. Always exciting. I remember my first two in varsity action. Senior night after 4 years of playing.
Senior night.
43 seconds, the clock's running, 77-39. We're going to wait and see if Coach sends a few up. Good no call there. That ball's knocked out of bounds, and they're going to give it to the Warriors. Why anyone at this point would argue that, I wouldn't know. 27 seconds. We'll take a quick break after the game, but then we'll be back with you with a little bit of postgame. Tyler Summers, he's going to go to the line to shoot two. By the time he gets there, it should be the end of the game. So I don't know if they let him shoot them or they stop the clock or the game will be over. I mean, it's not going to impact the game other than Summers. Well, they do stop it.
Tyler Summers will shoot two.
And Summers scores there and gets that one. Making it 78-39, 5.6 to go. So good night, good bounce back win for Wes-Del. We'll talk about some stats and some other things, see if we get a couple players or a coach to come up after this one. But it will be 78-39 is how this one ends. The Warriors pull out a victory. That'll be their sixth win of the year. APA falls to 0-13. Wes-Del moves to 6-8. We'll be back here real quick with our postgame show. Presented by Bob Todd's American Pest Professionals. You need somebody that's going to get rid of your bugs, call Bob. You're watching Wes-Del Sports on the Wes-Del Sports Network. All right, we're back here. We've got some stats to get to, and then we should have some guys coming up, I believe, from Coach McLaughlin sending a few players up. So let's talk some stats. Coach Nuckols, give us the highlights tonight. A lot of scoring for Wes-Del and not so much for APA. Go ahead.
Yeah, for the Warriors, Josiah Love ended up with 26. Corbin Price had 14 points and 5 rebounds. Kay Pretorius, 12 points, 6 steals. Travis Bunch had 6 points and 8 rebounds. Trey Adams, 6 points and 8 assists. For the Jets, Zayden Finley led the way with 12 points, followed by Fathauer with 9, and both Scott and Eldridge chipped in 6.
There you have it. Pretty well sums it up. Great night. Good balanced scoring for the Warriors. Love with 26, Price with 14, Pretorius with 12, and you can't count out Travis Bunch's 6. Those were big ones. Sounds like a good evening for Wes-Del. And let's talk to Coach Hanson. Hanson, you've got the schedule in front of you. Where do we go from here? What's next week look like?
We are back here again next Friday against Randolph Southern. So we are back on air again next Friday against Randolph Southern and then next Saturday at Cowan. So big MEC weekend for the Warriors. So big win tonight to come out of here. This this weekend, split it, and then back again next week, two more conference games.
So we're at home on Friday, and then we're at Cowan on Saturday. That's a tough one. One thing about our conference schedule that a lot of people don't realize is we did leave the conference for a few years and went into the RAC, and when we came back to the conference, the only way to really fit us in was they had to put us in a lot of double weekends. And that's pretty tough, especially, you know, you look at weekends in the past like Wapahani, Daleville. That's a really tough weekend. You know, a lot of emotions running high. And we've seen that happen in the past where those conference weekends can be tough, where I know one year in particular we beat Wapahani and then we turn around and we lose a tough one against Daleville. But there's a lot of emotion in those conference games. You're wanting to win them. It looks like we've got some players headed out of the locker room. Don't know if they're coming up here. This might be one of our guys. Not sure. Nope. Looks like they're just walking out to talk.
Here comes some of them. Here comes, looks like Josiah. And
here we go. We got a few guys coming up. So I'm going to let these guys go. They're going to turn it over to these players. So thank you, Coach Hanson. Thank you, Coach Nuckols. You guys go do dad duty or whatever you've got to do. And we'll be back here next Friday with you guys. So appreciate your time and appreciate the stats. Looks like we have a couple players trying to get through and get down here.
Big guy coming through.
So we've got some Josiah Love. Looks like sophomores coming in. Grayson Mealy and Josiah Love. Josiah, come on in first or however you want to do it. Put on the headset there. Grayson Mealy, you can run. Try not to break everything, Grayson. That would be the start here. All right, Josiah, a 26-point game performance. I noticed in you a little difference tonight, and I think it had something to do with you weren't real happy with last night. Would that have a little bit of motivation in tonight?
That was definitely it.
So as you came into tonight, what, you know, was it basically just be more aggressive and go after it a little bit more? Last night was foul trouble. Mm-hmm. Did you have that in your mind too? Were those your two things? Stay out of foul trouble and be aggressive?
Yeah, those were my two things.
Those were your two things. So what was working for you tonight? I know early there were a couple of shots that you got frustrated with. It was like you kept trying and they just in and out or they roll off. It took you a while to find that. But when you did find it, what were you doing there in the zone? Did you have a spot in the zone where they just weren't covering and they get it to you and you knew you could turn right there and make that shot?
I mean, I know I could rip baseline every time because they were coming out and I could just rip baseline and get that easy layup every time,
And then I saw a couple of good baseline cuts as Jacob Grant on a couple of plays. He got into the middle of the zone. We've talked about this, remember, back into practices when I was still helping, that we talked about if the ball gets to the middle of the zone, don't stand, cut.
Yeah.
You did the baseline cut at least two or three times, and Jacob found you. He ended up with six assists in the first half, a lot of those going to you. And that was just because you moved without the ball. Did you notice that there were seams in the zone that you could get through?
Yeah, that low post was wide open whenever Jacob would come in and pass. He did really good tonight. I liked it.
He did a nice job. Coming into this game, I'm sure Coach, and we don't have to get into specifics, but I'm sure Coach challenged you guys last night after the game, and you came into this one. It looked like you guys knew, hey, we didn't put out our best effort last night. We want to change that. You go in here and you put up nearly 80 points tonight. It was a team effort. Was that the mindset? Was there any talk going on, or did you guys just know, hey, we didn't give our best last night, we got to come back?
We knew we just had to give our best tonight because last night was not us.
If you had it, would you like to have Shenandoah again?
Yeah, I would. I would actually.
Yeah, so that would be a great opportunity. So coming into next week, we have Randolph Southern on Friday night, and then we turn around and we head to Cowan. Out of those two MEC big games there, you guys are 6-8 right now. Yeah. A great opportunity. Would you like to see it? I'm sure you want to see us get to 8-8, but are those two big games for you? And you're looking to try to get us back to 500, maybe heading into February during tournament time.
Yeah, that would be nice. We need two wins next weekend. We really need it.
It's fantastic. I thought you did a nice job bouncing back, getting that 26 after I think last night you had 8.
Yeah.
Did a nice job. You moved without the ball really well, but congratulations on the win. And you can pass that over, or I can talk to Grayson and you can stay. It looks like you're stuck here for a minute, so maybe you can add some things. Grayson, you're up here. You're one of the other sophomores. Mm-hmm. I'm just going to tell you before you watch it, as your father, I had a bet going that you were fouling out tonight. It looked like that, especially when the ball got stripped from you and you decided the best thing to do was to foul the guy because he stole it from you. But other than that, tonight, you know, you're coming into this one. I talked to Josiah about this. You guys were pretty frustrated last night with the way things were. Was this just a bounce back? Was this kind of a message game to everybody that we're not going away, we're coming back?
Yeah, we got a nice chewing out after last night's game, and we came in a lot more focused today.
I'd say you probably deserved a little bit of that chewing out last night. The effort wasn't where it was. And one thing with this team is if there is a little bit of adversity, let's say foul trouble, especially last night with Corbin, and Josiah. It seems like we lose a little bit, but tonight there was some foul trouble and you guys adjusted. Are you trying to work through that where next guy up, next guy steps up, even when you lose your top two scorers in foul trouble, and then the next guy's just got to step up? Tonight, I thought Jacob Grant did a nice job of establishing himself, but also another guy, we can't play that we didn't see this. I think Travis Bunch had a career night tonight with 6 points. So you got a lot out of there, but is that kind of the mindset now that coach wants to see? Listen, these guys get in foul trouble. Some of you other guys have to step up. Is that what we're looking for?
Yeah, it's a key thing he's been preaching in practice.
Yep. The other thing I noticed tonight is the pressure worked a little bit better in the zone for both of you guys. This is a question. Was that something we wanted to establish? We started in our switching man-to-man, and was that the plan? And then slowly we were going to switch it over to Fury. Was that what the game plan was?
Yeah, we knew when we started speeding them up, they'd get pretty shaky.
Yep, and it looked that way. So great job not fouling out. You proved your dad wrong, which you're good at doing. Josiah, great job. 26 points tonight. You did a nice job. Both of you, an excellent job of bouncing back after a really tough loss.
Yeah.
And congratulations to both of you. I'm sure you guys have plans tonight. Grayson, I'd like to know your plans before you leave, so either text me or come up here and talk to me. Otherwise, you're grounded. But thank you, and have a good evening. Good job, guys.
All right, thank you.
Thank you. All right, we got Coach McLaughlin coming up here next. Talk to him. I'm sure this – Coach, it never stops for you. You've got students coming up here. I mean, you've got students coming up here asking you questions. I'm sure those are health related for health class, projects due. Everything, it never stops. I mean,
I know.
How can you balance it all? But all right, let's just talk about the elephant in the room. Last night was not a good one. We didn't get a chance to talk to you last night, number one, because you were busy, as Grayson would say, giving a good chewing out to the guys. But he said it was well deserved, and I think it was more challenging the guys because your expectations are much higher than what they gave. So talk about last night in the sense that game's over, but you've got to turn right around and play again.
Yeah, well, that's not very – you've known me long enough. That's hard for me to turn the page. I'm still mad about it right now, even though we just won. So I just thought we gave a terrible effort last night. I didn't think we played hard. I didn't think we did things that try to make us successful. We didn't take care of the ball. We played soft and all those things that – really have not been part of our program here since I've been here, and I didn't think it was a great representation of Wes-Del basketball. So I challenged them, is a nice word, I guess, to say. And we had a little talk in there afterwards, and I told them to go home and come back tomorrow if they're ready to play. And if they weren't, I wasn't going to put them in. We weren't going to watch guys not play hard tonight. We can make mistakes, and I've always said that as a coach. You're going to make mistakes. That's why they keep track of turnovers. But if you keep making the same mistake over and over, you didn't learn from that mistake. So I don't care. I don't want you to play scared not to make mistakes, but we got to play harder, smarter, all the things. And I thought at times we did tonight, you know.
And I know
we could say whatever we want about, you know, well, we think we were a better team. They took Alexandria to double overtime.
They did. They did.
They played some really close games.
They have some nice pieces that they haven't had in years past.
Right.
I'll say that for Corey Scott. He's got a nice group there, and they play hard all the way through even when they're down. But let's go back to a moment that I saw early and what you were doing. You know, a lot of people realize this is your last year, and it could be easy in your last year to, in a program that you've had for 10 years, to let a few things here go, let a few things here, but it's not happening. Here's what I saw tonight. You had a senior who was settling for some threes early,
right,
and you took that senior out. We talked about it, Coach Hanson and I. I saw the redirection on the bench. Next thing you know, in the second half, I see that senior shot fake, put it on the floor, get into 15 to 10 feet and start making jump shots. So even as a senior who is in his last year, a coach who we know now has announced this is his last year, nothing's stopping when it comes to the education of a basketball player and the education of a man. You're saying, listen,
right,
this is not working for us. Bring him out. I'm sure he's frustrated, but he reacts perfectly, gets coached, goes back in, makes the adjustments, and started playing really well. And also, those are the things that I'm seeing. So I want to say on behalf of the district and on behalf of the school, kudos to you for not just saying, you know what, I'm still going to challenge these guys.
Yeah.
I'm not giving up.
Well, yeah, I mean, early in the game, Cade settled for a couple shots that were quick shots I didn't think were great shots. So I said, let's pass up the good shots for great shots. And I thought we started doing that a little bit better. And then even before we at the halftime, a ball went to a one reversal inside to Cade, back out, and then reversed around to Cade for a wide open three with his feet set. And I thought he knocked that down. He's running back. I said, that's a great shot. We'll take that shot. And even the one he missed in transition that was quick, we'll take transition threes if your feet are set. But, yeah, I mean, I wasn't – There was no – that was equal opportunity last night after the game about who was getting yelled
absolutely.
At. I mean, Travis got a little bit of it because I didn't think he was doing his job leading. He did a better job tonight. Cade, same thing. I mean, all the way down. We went all the way down. Guys that even get in the game got a little bit of yelling at. So, you know, we're not going to stop.
They practice together, so the ownership's on everybody.
Right, and you know what? I said, you know, we're going to do this the right way. So I thought we came back out tonight, gave a lot better effort. I mean, we moved the ball better. We attacked better. We still have things at times where I think we could finish better when we get to the rim and do a better job of that. But, you know, everybody from down all the way through, that's part of the reason why we sent Josiah up, had a great game. But Grayson and Travis and those guys do a lot of things that the normal person that just sits up here in the crowd doesn't notice. But, man, they get those guys shots. And Travis and Grayson rip down a lot of rebounds and are learning that, you know, if I'm coming down with that ball tough, they're not going to take it from me. So, you know, it was a better effort. I thought it was a better – and you're right, we're not going to stop coaching them. We're going to keep coaching them all the way to the very end. That's I wouldn't want it any other way. And I don't think they do either. If they do, that's too bad.
Speaking of that, next week you've got a big one, Randolph Southern here at home, and then you turn around and go on the road in a tough environment in a county rivalry with Cowan.
Yeah.
You're sitting at 6-8. You know, getting back to 8-8 is definitely a goal. You have an opportunity in front of you, but you got to have a good week of practice to make that happen. But, you know, there's some pieces there at Randolph Southern. They've got some height. They've got some athleticism. That's not going to be an easy one. And then anytime we play Cowan, it's a 50-50 ball all the time.
Right. It's probably going to be – when we go to Cowan, and it's almost always homecoming or whatever they call their thing over there. So, since they don't have football almost every year when we go there. So, it'll be loud and packed. And the weird and interesting thing for next weekend is kind of preparing for the same team because a really good guard on both teams and a 6'8 big guy on both teams.
Yeah.
That we have to figure out how – obviously, we don't have that. So, we got to figure out how we're going to do it. And I know what we want to do. I told him I'll have us ready and what we can do to go against that, but we're going to have to follow a game plan, which we're just going to have to do it. I mean, otherwise, we won't have a chance. So, we're going to have to do the things this week to prepare for that. But, yeah, two conference games. Always love back-to-back conference games for the 10 years I've been here. But but we'll play
someday them. We'll get that figured out.
I don't care now. we'll get anyway, I thought it was better. I thought, you know, again, next week, you're right, we're going to have to be ready to go. And, you know, I don't know. I guess my bet – we had people that were betting. I know I heard you had bet that Grayson, what was it, that was going to foul out?
Yeah, I thought it was going to happen.
They didn't call much, or I probably would have.
Yeah.
My bet was I said I wanted a dollar for every time you mentioned my pink shirt tonight. But
no, I didn't say it once. Well, I was taking it easy. Yeah. But shifting gears on one last thing, and not trying to get you too emotional here, but I know you know this is family for you. You've always, when you break down, you talk family. I just wanted to say on behalf of everybody that may not know, you know, you've been dealing with some stuff off the court that you've been trying to work through and some health conditions with your mom.
Yeah.
I know that she had a scare for you, and that's been tough, and your mind's been in a lot of places. But on behalf of Wes-Del, Wes-Del Sports Network, and all of us here in the district, we want to send well wishes out to your mom on her recovery. And I know that's been on your mind, and I know that's hard in your last season here. You've got a lot of emotion. Each game you realize this is the last time I'm going to coach against or at this place. And I know these coaches, I see you talk to every coach as you go to these places. So you've got a lot of emotion wrapped up. You know, your family's so embedded. You know, Rachel's your daughter, your youngest, is a manager on the team. And so everybody's a lot going on. But on behalf of us, our thoughts, prayers, everything go out to your mom and maybe your dad because he has to play a little bit of caregiver too.
Yeah,
and maybe you on having to deal with all of it. But I know you dealt with that all through the last two weeks. She's home now doing
She's
better.
Home. She's home. We had a big scare. Had a pretty big heart attack and airlifted to – you know, I guess one of the things I would say is just remember – because this is my last year here, but just remember coaches have other
Families.
Things going on and stuff going on that doesn't always involve just what you see here on the sidelines. It's emotional. You know, my best friend from high school is here tonight, so I got – you know, people are coming back, so bringing a lot of emotions. One of my first assistant coaches was here last night.
I told him never to come again.
Yeah, no, I told him the same thing.
Yeah.
but there's a lot of people that are coming to games and then, you know, the stuff going on at home. But just remember coaches are – people and families, and so when you're out there, try to remember that. But I appreciate that. It's been my pleasure to be here, as I've said, but You know, we're not done yet, so we'll keep going at it, and we'll go after it again next week and see if we can find a way to get one here at home on Friday night.
Well, I see them all waiting for you, so yeah. I appreciate your time. So why don't you head down there, and I'll catch up with you here in a few
minutes.
Right.
So all right.
Good
Thanks.
Talking to
Thanks.
You. That's head coach
Thank you.
John McLaughlin. That's win 105 for McLaughlin here. Again, he's the all-time winningest coach at Wes-Del, so 105 wins. I've lost my other two buddies because I sent them away. It's Mr. Producer and myself here. So next week we will be back at home. We will bring you Randolph Southern here from Richard E. Johnson Gymnasium. Great night. It was elementary night along with our induction of our inaugural class of the Hall of Fame. But a big win for the Warriors and a big win for everybody here in Wes-Del. So we'll see you next week from Richard E. Johnson on Friday night. Randolph Southern comes to town to take on the Warriors. So on behalf of Mr. Romine, Mr. Producer, I'm signing off tonight. Thank you for watching the Wes-Del Sports Network.